on tour is sponsored by Coca-Cola.
Frozen Peas, respected member of our community for years, determined to always do just the right thing, committed to support the growth of our children, and effective at lowering bad cholesterol. Frozen Peas, courage, integrity, fresh ideas. This message paid for by the Friends of Frozen Peas.
If you're not voting, then who are you electing?
You ever wish you could hang out with rock stars on tour? Now you can. Join us for an inside look at J Records recording artist Silvertide as the band comes home to play a Halloween bash at Philadelphia's famed Electric Factory. It's music, mayhem, and much more.
It's always great. You always end up getting drunk with your friends. They get to see what we do every other night of the week, all over the world.
Sometimes, usually they're really stressful because you got all your friends and family, but once that's out of the way, they're awesome always, you know, just being able to come back.
I always like it because this is where I always saw all the concerts, even with you. In high school, back in the day, I saw shows here at the TLA and the Electric Factory. So it's always cool.
It's the same and it's different at the same time. It's the same as any other city because we pull in the bus and, you know, none of us really get to go home. We have stuff to do, sound check, you know, press, the show, meet and greet after the show, stuff like that. It's different because all your family comes out. It's kind of hectic, but cool at the same time.
You know, 12 o'clock, the day of the show, can I get on the list? I need tickets. And then you're like, ah, shit. You know, like I handed the list in last night. But, you know, it's always fun though.
I guess it goes back to us being in high school, and I went to Father Judd with Kevin Frank on drums, and Mark and Walt, and Brian went to Archbishop Brian, which is 10 minutes away.
I knew Mark growing up. We lived like four houses down from each other, and we grew up together, and we met Walt. I was a year ahead of Walt and Mark. They were a year below me.
I guess Mark and Walt were playing separately acoustic stuff, and Kevin and I were playing very loud electric stuff. And we met up at this coffee house. It was all acoustic. And basically, we saw Walt and Mark playing, and then that was a singer with a rhythm guitar. And then when we played, it was lead guitar and drums, that's it. And we sort of knew that was a sign, you know, let's get together and do something.
Mark had songs, and Nick and Kevin had songs. And it turned out that the first song that they ever did was Blue Jeans, and they wrote that their first practice. Like, it wasn't even a practice, they were just hanging out, and they wrote Blue Jeans. And Nothing Stays, because that was about my basement, the first line. The sitting here in a dark, cramped basement, I think that's the line.
So they started playing together, and a little bit later, Mark called me and asked me if I wanted to start playing with the band. And
Brian's like, well, I'm in school, I'm playing in like 2 or 10 other bands. And we said, well, we promise this rock band will be much more fun than your jazz project. And I think we were right.
Well, folks finally seen the simple view, and I've seen a way out.
I said, give me that. Rock, 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 come on.